Hello, my name is Jim Keller. I'm a professor of pharmacy medicine and oncology out of the University of Texas at Austin and the Health Science Center in San Antonio. Today I want to talk about the NCCN guidelines for chemotherapy-induced prevention, or CINV, in the role of non-oral antiemetic agents as part of these guidelines. This first one is the NCCN guideline. This is for highly emetogenic chemotherapy. And the key thing here is to look at day one and the options. Again, for highly emetogenic chemotherapy, the option is a three-drug regimen of a 5-HT3, an NK1, and dexamethasone. Dexamethasone is consistent throughout. The 5-HT3 can vary either from the first generation to second generation agents, and or the route of administration and the means of administration from oral to IV to extended release patch and or extended release subcutaneous administration. The NK1s can vary either by oral or the IV route of administration. In addition, instead of an NK1, the NCCN guidelines also suggest you could use olanzapine, again with your choice of 5-HT3 or dexamethasone. From the moderate standpoint, again, here again on day one, it's going to be a 5-HT3 antagonist with your same combinations of NK1s and that backbone of dexamethasone. That again would be for what we call the high moderate emetogenic agents on the higher end of the scale. The other option is just to use a two-drug regimen of 5-HT3 and dexamethasone. For delayed, in most cases, it's going to be a continuation of the dexamethasone, and depending on which 5-HT3 is used, it either will be continued or not continued if you're using the extended release and the other formulations of the 5-HT3, additional days treatment would not be needed. As far as the guidelines go for management of breakthrough and continued emesis, the principles here is to use a different class of drugs than what you've tried. Round-the-clock administration, scheduled administration, always preferred to PRN dosing. The route, PR route here may not be feasible if patients are having a hard time with nausea and vomiting in the past. You want to make sure you ensure hydration. And again, you have the therapeutic options for breakthrough, these adjuvant therapies such as olanzapine, lorazepam, the phenothiazines, cannabinoids are not used to a great extent, and some other adjuvant areas, agents such as haloperidol, metoclopramide, and such can also be used. In summary, again, we've highlighted that the NCCN guidelines suggest a three-drug regimen of a 5-HT3 in one of the various routes of administration or forms of administration for extended release, or an NK1, which are either given orally or by injection, and the backbone of this is the dexamethasone. These are recommended for prevention of both HEC and MEC. The two-drug combination of a 5-HT3 in either an alternative route or method of administration plus dexamethasone can still be an option for lower-level MEC agents. Many other types of therapeutic approaches are recommended for patients who have breakthrough or have problems with therapy of either the two or three drug regimen, and I listed those previously. I want to thank you for your time again, and goodbye.